Skiathos, one of the countless Greek islands. There's a proverb that says, the more things change, the more they're the same. One of the old Olympian gods, looking down on Skiathos today, wouldn't find much change. But there'd be some changes, of course. Take this man, Mikhali Yanides, for example. He plies a trade that was old when Odysseus set out for Troy, selling gear to the sailors for their ships. But now, and here's a change, oil to drive those little ships, and oil as well for the women to light their lamps and heat their stoves. Costa, for example, is such a sailor. He's off to the mainland for corn, and instead of whistling to the old gods for a wind, he buys his fuel from Mikhali. A good life, Mikhali, a useful life. Of course, there are commodities you can't provide. Luck, for example. Here's Yorgo as a case in point. He's had nothing but bad luck since his wife died. And now two nets damaged and one lost in a single night's work. Once Yorgo would have blamed all this on the gods. In his heart, maybe he still does. But Yorgo can't afford more bad luck just now. He has to find a dowry for his daughter, Anna. She is to wed Nico, the son of Mikhali.
Σε λίγο, Άννα. Μόλις τα βγάλω αυτά έξω να στεγνώσουν.
The lad himself is on his way home after 5 years at sea. And you wonder what Nico will think of this girl, playing the housewife to her father, even telling him not to be late back.
Καλή είναι η Άτιμη.
Το εκείνο που εύχομαι είναι να είναι ο γιος μου καλός για αυτή.
Μιχάλη.
Γεια σου, Αντώνη.
Μιχάλη.
Now, you could tell us plenty about this diffident fellow, Andoni, eh, Mikhali? And so could every ship's chandler since seafaring began. For Andoni is an eternal type, the sailor who loses things. Goodness knows what it is now. Oh, well, there was probably such a sailor in Jason's crew when they sought the Golden Fleece.
Να σου πω λίγη την αλήθεια. Χάθηκε.
Έλα, πάμε στο μαγαζί να δούμε αν μπορούμε να βρούμε ένα άλλο. Για πες μου τώρα τι έκασε, Αντώνη.
στον καπετάνα Αντώνη.
Καλημέρα.
Ξέρεις το γιο μου τον Νίκο, ε?
Μικάλη, your wife's a chatterbox. Natural enough, you'll say, with the news of her son's return at long last to tell the whole island.
Έπειτα από τόσο καιρό, ναι, δεν είναι απίστευτο. Πήγε παντού, είδε όλο τον κόσμο. Κι όμως γυρίζει στο νησάκι του. Ναι, έρχεται, έρχεται.
Good heavens, Antony, of all things for a sailor to lose.
Κύριε Μιχάλη, ένα τηλεγράφημα για σένα.
Αχ, από τον Νίκο.
Από τον Νίκο. Έρχεται ο Νίκος.
A messenger swifter than Mercury ever was. Even good news travels fast now. Nico is nearly home. And Nico starting the last lap. Taxi to Athens, bus to Volos, boat to Skiathos.
Ώστε γυρίσεις στο νησί σου να παντρευτείς. Και τι είναι αυτό που σε φοβίζει?
Τίποτα.
Εγώ δεν θα κάνει τη ρησία αν κάποιος με έκανε ένα καλό προξενιό. Άνα τα καθεδάκια.
Τι τρέχει? Τι συμβαίνει?
Δεν βλέπεις? Αφού βάζω νερό. Άσε μας.
Ναι, αλλά τι είναι καλό προξενιό?
Now here's an old, old story. 5 years away, Nico, and yet you say your home doesn't draw you. And why? Because the face of a girl in a 5-year-old photograph doesn't please you. But Nico, as your cynical friend observes, beauty isn't everything. It passes. But a good dowry, well, one can live with that. And anyway, Nico, time has not stood still. So don't be too reluctant to return.
Ελάτε, λοιπόν, θα φύγουμε καμιά φορά.
Πάμε, δεν πρεπτένουμε άλλο.
Mm-hmm.
θα ξεχάσεις.
Γίνεται τέτοιο πράγμα.
Κοίταξε μην το ξεχάσεις, έτσι.
Mrs. Mikhali is still worrying lest Captain Yorgo fails to produce that dowry. Reassure her, Mikhali. Tell her you know what you're about.
Ο Νίκος από στιγμή σε στιγμή θα είναι εδώ.
Μη στεναχωριέσαι, Μαρία. Καπτάν Γιώργης είναι εντάξει. Θα του μιλήσω.
Κοίταξε, μην το ξεχάσεις.
Όχι, όχι.
Ναι.
Στο υπόσχομαι.
Καλά.
Έλα. Έκυψω.
But how are you going to do it? Why not drop a hint, for example, that Nico is very nearly home?
Ξέχασα να σου πω. Ο Νίκος έρχεται από την Αθήνα.
Island hasn't changed, Mikhali, in 100 or more years. Except that here you are, bringing bottled gas to two old ladies to light their house and heat their stove, instead of them having to break their backs gathering sticks of thorn and twisting tallow wicks. Ah, well, progress. Maybe one day you'll have a mechanized mule. Stavros, a rich man. His wealth comes from a source as ancient as the fishermen's, for he owns nearly all the island's olive groves. For 3,000 years since the first olive trees came to Athens from the east, that generous plant has been the treasure of the Greeks. Since Yorgo seeks Tasso's help, it looks as if Anna's dowry is to be an olive grove.
Κανένας δεν έχει τόσο όμορφη κόρη σαν την Άννα σου.
Poor Yorgo can't bring himself to put the tip of his tongue to a syllable. It's a heavy thing for any man to get a daughter off his hands. And Yorgo's scared stiff that you won't consider his offer for the dowry worthy of either your son or Anna.
Γιώργη, αδερφέ μου, κάτι σου συμβαίνει.
Να σου πω την αλήθεια, ναι. Ο Τάσος ο Ζηφάκος θέλει να πουλήσει ένα ελαιόνα και σκεφτόμουν αν ήθελες να πάμε να τον δούμε μαζί σήμερα το απόγευμα.
So it is going to be an olive grove. Volos at last. But too soon for Nico. With only the sea passage to the island between him and marriage to that monkey-faced girl of the photograph.
Ο Νίκος. Βρε Κώστα, έρχομαι. Και συγχωρείς, βρήκα παρέα.
Στην υγεία του Νίκου.
Βίβα.
Τι ανυπομονησία θα έχεις να φτάσεις στο σπίτι σου, ε?
Όχι και τόσο.
Τι, να μην δεις τους δικούς σου ξανά?
Τους δικούς μου. Και βέβαια. Η αλήθεια είναι όμως πως μου κάνουν προξενιό με την πιο άσχημη κοπέλα του νησιού.
Όχι, δα. Και ποια είναι αυτή? Ποια είναι, ρε Νίκο?
Will these old friends of yours tell you the truth about her, Nico? That she's the island beauty. Not a queen hurl. They're more likely to tell you that the girl's a monster.
Φουκαρά μου, Νίκο. Είσαι άτυχος. Άτυχος. Στην υγειά της Άννας.
Στην υγειά της.
Taxi to Athens, bus to Volos, and now boat to a waiting Skiathos.
Και βέβαια έχω. Πόσο θες. Δεν έχω ξεμείνει ποτέ. Το παιδί κοίταξε σήμερα το πρωί, όπως και κάθε μέρα.
Καλά. Καλά, βράδυ. Ρώτησα. Μπα.
Αντώνη, you're an ungrateful wretch. Just for once, you say you remembered to fill your tanks with oil and can snap your fingers at the man you depend on. Your ancestors would have forgotten to thank the gods for a wind in the right quarter. Mikhali, you've heard his back. How calm you are. Quite the old traveler. But wondering, of course. what he'll look like. What you and Maria will look like to him after all these years. This was Anna's great day, and Nico's. And so it is, of course. But nobody will be allowed to forget that it is Yorgo who is betrothing a daughter, and Mikhali a son. And that this, in so small a community, is everybody's business. And so there are many eyes to watch keenly, and see that the thing is done properly, with no rite omitted, no ancient custom neglected. Seems unhappy. But the face of his bride is still the face in that old photograph. He may not look upon the real girl until his feet have crossed iron on her threshold.
Thank you.
Athinai, Andoni. Is this a second thought? Is it possible that perhaps you didn't remember to fill your tanks with oil in spite of all that bluster? You are indeed the original Cretan sailor. Everything ready for the voyage but the boat. You may be master of the feast, Mikhali, but it seems you are not to be left to rejoice in peace. But since when did the sheep consider the shepherd's comfort? Ah, Mikhali, you would not be the man you are if you forgot that though Nico the bridegroom is your son, you play father to every fisherman in the island.